Hello there, YouTube. Dr. Carlo Ojeda with DrER.tv. I got a clinical case for you, but the actual picture doesn't demonstrate the procedure, so I am sorry about that. Here's the video.
Picture is worth many, many words, you know.
As you can see, this is a severely swollen hand. The patient's on blood thinners and she's had an IV puncture and the hand swelled up like that. It's basically hematoma. But here's the kicker, it's a couple days old. So usually when a blood clot happens, that blood clot gets gelatinous. It basically forms a hard surface of gel and tissue. And if you try to drain that, all that comes out is this jello, so the needle drainage does not work. Actually, the patient, if you can see on the side of the hand, there's a little bit of bleeding because the husband's patient, tried to drain that hematoma. And I was telling the patient that I don't think a needle drainage will help, and trying to open up the hand will make it bleed a lot, and then maybe, because she's on blood thinners, we would be unable to stop it. So I was very, very hesitant as to whether or not to perform this procedure. So I called the orthopedic doctor and I said, hey, what would you do? They recommended that I didn't drain it, that I just treat the patient's discomfort, that maybe we'll have a 24 to 48 hour follow-up in the office. I called the general surgeon. I sent him pictures of that video that you just saw. Same thing, don't drain it, elevate it, use some pain medicine, follow up in the office in 24 to 48 hours. But the patient's husband was very upset. I mean, almost to the point of irate, you know, like he was like, you gotta drain this. And I said, I don't know, you know, I got two consultants telling me not to do so. And there's certainly nothing dangerous, but it is very uncomfortable. The patient was in a lot of pain. So I decided, hey, listen, I'm gonna give it a try. I'm gonna put a thick needle, an 18 gauge needle, we'll suction it through, and we'll see what we get. If I don't get anything, I'm done. Use some pain medicine, you go home. So that was my judgment. That was what I wanted to do, and that's what I did. And I'm sorry I didn't capture that part of the procedure. The video I showed you, I captured because I was gonna use it for the consultation with the different specialists. So I was thinking, this isn't gonna be a procedure, this is not gonna be anything to watch, there's not gonna be anything there. And I put the needle in, pull out, and just completely watery liquid blood came out. So even though that hematoma had been there 2 days, because the patient was on blood thinners, it was actually a drainable hematoma, which is usually not the case. So lesson learned, if they're on blood thinners, they have a good chance of being drainable even if it's been 24 to 48 hours out. It can be done. So if you are in the medical field, we'll be going into, if you're a nurse practitioner, this story might help a patient of yours in the future, because the patient insisted, the family insisted on doing something, and this time they were actually correct. And I get to learn something new. I get to improve my practice with future patients, so it's a win-win case. I hope you enjoy this. I'm gonna post a video again here so you see the hematoma. And I hope you learned something. And if you did, make sure you share it, make sure you like it, make sure you comment, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye, guys.
Picture is worth many, many words, you know.